most interesting quarterback situation is where?
Wow, most interesting. Oh, man, there's a couple of them out there. I mean, I definitely believe Cleveland is interesting. I think with Johnny, and I think he's played a little bit better and seems to be more focused on it. And then you have my buddy Josh there, who's kind of bounced around and being a veteran guy. I think anytime you have that sort of dynamic, I think that one's going to be really, really interesting as we play it out. I mean, I think Buffalo is interesting from a lot of standpoints in A, who's going to get the nod, and then B, when you look at the entire team and the talent that they have, you just wonder, are any of those guys going to be good enough to help them turn that corner? Because I think they could really be competitive in that division and maybe in the AFC with a lot of the pieces they have, but we know so much of it's about quarterbacks.
Would you start Manziel week one?
I probably would not. But again, I'm on the outside looking in, and I think it's always easier to go veteran, and if veteran doesn't play well, go to the rookie. I think it's much harder to throw rookie in and then pull back and go to the veteran. So, I mean, I think it, you know, every indication I've got is that Josh has played well, maybe not so much in that last preseason game, but played well and definitively ahead. I think you have to start that direction, see how it goes. But then if you feel really strongly with where Johnny's at, it's easier to make that move to him as opposed to putting all that pressure on him early in the year.
Yeah, but you got to decide. You know, you can't be sort of pregnant. You got to decide if Manziel is your future, then let's find out, because you could find out at the end of the year that it's not Manziel and it's not Josh, that you're going to be drafting a quarterback. But it feels like you're delaying the inevitable of just saying, let's see what we have here. And you know what? If for better or for worse, we're going to find out.
Right. I mean, again, I think there's always that idea. But if you go in with that idea, you're basically saying if you're not sure Johnny's the guy, I think you're basically saying to the team, well, we're going to scrap this year, and we're going to play for next year. And, again, there's teams that do that, and I don't think there's a problem with that if that's the approach you want to take going in. But if you take the approach that we feel we can be competitive this year, I think you have to start the season saying what quarterback gives us the best chance to compete early. Mm-hmm. And then if we can't compete and we fall apart, then I think that's what we see every year. Okay, veteran, no matter how you've played, we're going to the young guy and we're going to see where he's at this year and what we have to do in the offseason. But I think most teams come in believing they can be competitive to some degree, and I think you owe it to your team to put the best product on the field that can help you be competitive early and then make your decisions based on where you're at, you know, 3-4 games in or halfway through the season.